You know, someone once said to me, "Oh, you big nose jock wop. Come on, lighten up, it's only a joke." To which I said, "Well, I don't find that very funny, Mr. Lloyd Webber." Then I poured half a pint of cream down the front of his trousers and hit him 8 times in the back of the head with a ladder. He didn't like that very much, so I said, "Come on, lighten up, it's only slapstick."
You should have got yourself a waterproof husband.
Jokes help us cope, like for Jill, who lost her husband Keith in a drowning accident.
Perhaps he thought he was a saltwater Keith.
Duncan Dead Hugh.
Or for Keith's friends, for whom humour helped them through the trauma of just having fished him out the water.
They're chucking back in!
Here we go!
Are you actually talking at the conference? Or?
Well, in a way, I'm doing the comedy bit at the end.
Oh, that's you?
Yeah, the after dinner thing.
Oh,
yeah.
I think it's really good because, you know, it's serious all day.
I know, and you want a bit of light. Actually, I'm a bit nervous about it because I think they're all expecting sort of traditional jokes.
Right.
And I'm not really, I haven't really mastered the traditional joke form. You know, the I say. My fly's got no nose, then how does it smell? Well, it's got 1,000 eyes, and that sort of compensates.
Yeah.
You know, how many kangaroos does it take to change a tap? They can't. At best, they can locate the source of the water leak by boinging up and down inside your house to see if that somehow affects the water pressure. But even then, they're going to be hard put to do anything about it unless one of them happens to have the right copper connecting mechanism in her sack of babies. What's big and small at the same time? A big egg.